Gray. Can you please briefly introduce yourself?
So my name is Eric Jones, aka Dr. Dapper, founder and CEO of LFL Shoes, which is a designer's dress shoe company based in Fayetteville, Arkansas. And I'm originally from Arkansas, but I'm out here in Atlanta just networking and connecting with people out here. My company will be sponsoring a New Year's Eve party today while I'm out here. So yeah, that's where I'm from. I'm 22 years old, born in Helena, Arkansas, went to school at the University of Arkansas in Fayetteville, and majored in fashion, then jumped out full-time into entrepreneurship with my shoe company.
All right, Eric, so what's the mission and purpose of your company?
So, like, my mission and purpose has changed kind of over the years since I first started. Like, my first intentions for the company were to, like, offer dress shoes, or designer dress shoes, and luxury style dress shoes for, like, a middle-class family so they can, like, break grounds in fashion without breaking their wallets. But over time, it's transitioned into, like, trying to offer my culture or something or black men, because I want to promote, like, the dapper look for men, and when I build a platform with my company, I'll be able to build my own personal platform as well. Like, I've been building both at the same time. So, like, that's my mission, is to, like, give my culture, like, women, men, their kids, and, like, just anybody, just, like, dress shoes that they can wear, and make dress shoes more casual for men to wear all the time. Because, like, back in the day, like, black men used to walk down the street for no reason in a suit, just to let people know, like, okay, we got business, we're, like, out trying to make moves, this and that. But it's changed so much over time that I think we need to flip the switch in the culture and, like, bring the more dapper and the classic look back to our culture.
So what does LFLS Shoes mean to you?
It means a lot to me. It's like, I'm so passionate about it because of so many things that I went through in, like, my early life as a kid and, like, recently when I first started it. So as a child, my mom's first lady, stepdad's pastor, I played the drums in church, so they tried to keep me in, like, a little suit or whatever we could afford back then. And but where I come from is, like, holes in the wall, roaches, like, rats, and just coming from, like, a hard background. So when I graduated and stuff, well, I had to take care of my grandma when I was younger. So it started, like, way back then. Like, my childhood was just, like, work, school, take care of my grandma. And so I guess my entrepreneurship spirit, like, started back then. All I could do was grind and had to mature real early. And my grandma ended up passing in 2010. And that hurt me too, like, a lot, because she took care of me. She raised me. My mom was out working. Then I got to high school. And when I graduated from high school and got to college, my dad passed in 2013. So that hit me pretty hard too. I had to go back to the funeral, like, before college started, then come back to college and get started. And I majored in fashion, places to draw and stuff like that. And the dapper look kind of still stuck with me. And then it transitioned, like, just gradually got more and more and more dapper or whatever over time. And then, like, maybe my junior year, I decided I wanted to be an entrepreneur because my mom worked so hard all the time and barely making ends meet still, like, 2 or 3 jobs. And I was like, dang, I want to do my own thing because I don't want to put a cap on what I'm worth. And I don't want to, like, just get out into, like, the corporate world and just be, like, tied down in that. So she got with me. She started putting money into it, too, helped me get my first samples. And then she ended up passing right before I graduated college last December. So after that, I was like, I ain't got nothing to lose. I'm just going to jump out, like, full-time on faith because you never know what God got for you. And I feel like she just, everybody had a, like, task in my life. Like, my grandma helped me get to, like, high school or middle school. My dad helped me get through high school. And my mom helped me get through college. And after that, that was it. She passed the baton on to me. And I had something very unique with a dress shoe company that no black male at the age of 22, like, had started from the country, like, in Arkansas. So I was like, man, let me just stick with it and just keep pushing because I never know what'll happen. And it's been hard, but I don't care. I ain't got no moves, and the passion I have for it is so deep. And I do it for so many different reasons. Like, I can't stop. So that's like.
So where do you receive your inspiration for creating each shoe style? And can you go into a bit of detail about it?
Yeah, so I feel like I'm unique and I try to have my own, like, lane from everybody else. Because, like, one of the other reasons I started doing dress shoes is because I see the same monk scrub, same wingtip, same loafer, like, from every company. So I wanted to offer something that was, like, unique and different for, like, the dress shoe industry. Which would, like, eventually make it more casual and make more, like, African-American guys want to, like, buy dress shoes and, like, eventually just switch their whole style around. So my inspiration just comes from me and looking at the market and seeing what's out there and adding my own little twist to what's already out there. And like, about a couple of styles, like my bachelor style is like a loafer style and it has like tassel detail on the front. It has like a gold zipper on the back of it. So the zipper is a non-functional feature, but I've never seen anyone add a zipper to the back of a man's loafer. And that was my first shoe I ever sketched. And it ended up being like the staple for like the product that everybody comes to my company for. And it's offered in red, black leather, and white with a gold toe cap now. And I have a royal blue one coming in as well with a gold toe cap. So just trying to expand slowly and offering different styles. But aside from like the luxury kind of like styles that pop a lot for the more like conservative or like, I don't know, chill gentleman, I got like mug straps, wingtips. I have some Chelsea boots, but I switched it up and named them Rachel boots because I added like a woven upper. Because everybody's been doing the same Chelsea boots, so I'm going to do something different. So I just see what's in the market, and I just add my little twist, and that's where I get my inspiration from.
Okay, Eric, so what vision do you have for your company in the next 5 years?
So I get that question a lot, and what I always say is like I can't imagine like where I'll be in 5 years because I receive so many blessings all year. Like if I just tried to put like a cap on what I would be doing like, in 5 years, it'll be like pretty crazy because like so many doors are open. I've had so many opportunities, so many blessings. Like I said, that I just think it'll just be like huge, like red carpet appearance. Like I'll be out doing philanthropy work, speaking here, speaking there, because of like the progress my company's made so fast. So I'm trying to be on Forbes, like GQ, like all kind of stuff. So I think that could happen, but I think it'll be like between 2 to 3 years and not 5, because 5 is a long time. And like I set these goals, but the path that I get to, like take to get to these goals is like always changing. So I mean, it could be 5, it could be 3, it could be 6, it could be 10. So I just stay the course and just stick with it, continue to grind.
So out of all the routes you could have chosen in the business world, what made you choose shoes?
I chose shoes mainly because, like I said, I've had the dapper look always, and I see people do suits, accessories. I see people do a lot of stuff like in fashion, but I've never seen anyone do like shoes. And if they did shoes, it was tennis shoes. So I was like, I wear dress shoes every day. I barely wear tennis shoes, so let me try to do something unique in the dress shoe industry. And my mom also likes shoes as well. And then I mentioned earlier that I could draw, so I started sketching shoes. So that's why I kind of went towards the shoe industry with the dress shoes. But I had started like accessories at first, and that wasn't working out and everything like that. But once you start spending money in like one industry or something, anything you're doing, you can probably like stick with it. So I became like, I fell in love with it, became real passionate about it. And then I sent my mom past, so I just stuck with it and just kept going. So that's why I did shoes.
So what is LFLS's relationship with the community in Fayetteville, Arkansas?
A few people connect with it in Fayetteville. Like once I offer like the casual kind of like styles that some dudes are going to be chill and laid back, because it's mostly like white area. We have a PW out there, and like, it's mostly a white area too. So I get a couple of customers to support there, but like I get some black women support there as well. But everything comes from online, so because I have like an online presence or whatever, and that's where I promote sales and website and stuff. So I get a little support in Fayetteville, but most comes from like people I don't even know, because like black people don't tend to not support people they know and post on social media and on my website, so I can support people in different areas. So I got some connections in Fayetteville with some people that buy shoes, but majority comes from like around the country. So
while on your website, I did see that LFLS will be moving towards selling women's shoes. So what will be the main force behind propelling the women's shoes forward, since LFLS is basically known as a men's shoe company?
Yeah. So when I released the men's shoes, a lot of women like the size too. So it began to like bring a lot of attention from like women as well. They were DMing me saying, hey, make women's shoes, and sending me texts, calling me, hey, we need some women's shoes, make some women's shoes. So this is kind of something that's been there since I started the company that released styles. So I mean, and it's only grown like more and more women like asking like, hey, can you make shoes with me? And when I released a picture of the women's shoe, like, women went crazy and they started tagging their girlfriends, like tagging their husbands and bodies for me. So social media and word of mouth would be like the biggest, I guess, force behind like that new venture in the company.
So what's one thing you've learned while as a CEO, founder, and owner of your own company that you would like to share with others?
So I've experienced that it's like real, real hard for like a black male or African-American male in the United States to start something like this, along with like our people not supporting us. The system has been set up for us not to like actually make it anyway. So it's been through this year, it's been very hard to like actually leverage like different things and like grow my brand through the year. But it's just like sacrifices you have to make and a lot of like trial and error and different things to go through. So I've learned that, you know, that's something to share.
So inspire, empower, uplift is the slogan of the Black Maverick. It sure is. So do you have any words of encouragement for the black community?
I would just say never give up on your dreams and your goals, because no matter where you come from, you can like do whatever you want. And don't hold back if you actually have something you want to do. Like if I had waited to start my shoe company, I wouldn't have my shoe company, because who would have known my mom was going to pass at the time she passed before I graduated. So I would just say, like, take that leap of faith, because you never know what God has for you. Until you take a leap of faith and you stand on the cliff of life, you'll never know. And you'll always ponder and wonder and always say, dang, if I had did that, I probably could have did this, because you'll see somebody else that's doing what you're thinking about doing right now. So I just say, go for it now and don't wait, because life is short. People die every day. So again, my name is Eric Jones, founder and CEO and designer of LFLF Shoes, aka Dr. Dapper as well. And you can reach me through social media at @the_EricJones or Dr. Dapper. And my company's Instagram is @LFLFShoes, and my website is www.lflfshoes.com.